Hello and welcome to another Data Sage training session with Learn at NorthStar. In today's session, we are going to take a look at another frequently asked Data Sage interview question, which is what is the difference between an in-link sort and an external sort using a sort stage in Data Sage? So let's get started. So to understand the differences, let's first take a look at the options that are available with an in-link sort. So we're taking the example of the remove duplicate stage, and if you go to the partitioning tab, you can specify the kind of partitioning along with the sorting. In the sorting options, we can see that there are two options available, stable and unique. Stable sort means that it is going to retain the sorting of the non-key columns that is coming from the previous stages. Unique sort means that it is going to remove the duplicates on the key columns on which we are performing the partitioning as well as sorting. Now let's go to the sort stage and see what are the options available with the sort stage. Going to the sort stage properties, we can see that there's an option called sort key mode, which has three possible values: don't sort previously grouped, don't sort previously sorted, or just go ahead and sort everything on the key columns that are defined within this stage. Don't sort previously sorted means that the sorting from the previous stage would be retained. Don't sort previously grouped basically means that the grouping from the previous stage would be retained. To understand the difference between the two, let's take a look at this example. So we have two data sets over here. In the first example, the data has been sorted. In the second example, the data has been grouped by column one. Column one has values, distinct values of 1, 2, and 3. So three groups have been formed, 1, 2, and 3. In both the data sets, we can see that the data has been sorted by these within these groups. But in the first example, we also see that the groups themselves have also been sorted. So 1 occurs, then 2 occurs, and 3. So 1, 2, and 3 groups with the key values of 1, 2, and 3 are in a sequence order. Whereas in the example of the data only being grouped by column 1, they are in random order, though the data within the partition or within the groups have been sorted. Now, don't sort previously sorted and don't sort previously grouped options both are going to have an impact in increasing the performance of your job, because we are not trying to repartition the data, we are retaining the partitioning from the previous stages. So some effort of the data sage job in doing a partitioning or a sorting again has been saved here. Now let's take a look at the other options available with the sort stage. Another thing to keep in mind with respect to the sort key mode option is that it is specified for each key. So when we are saying for a particular key that don't sort or don't sort previously grouped or previously sorted, we are specifying that the sorting or partitioning should not be performed again for that particular key. So if you specify any secondary keys and don't specify the don't sort previously sorted or grouped option for them, then the sorting would be performed. Now there's certain other options as well, like the allow duplicates option. So if you set it to false or true, accordingly duplicates would be retained or not. Another important option is a sort utility, which could be Data Sage or Unix. Data Sage utility means it will use the inbuilt Data Sage sorter. Unix means that it is going to use the Unix sort method. Data Sage is always preferred in these cases. Another option that we saw in the in-link sorting as well is the stable sort. So it works the same way. You can set it to true or false, basically meaning that the data that has already been sorted in the previous stage on any non-key columns, that sorting would be retained. Another important option that the sort stage has and the in-link sort does not have is the option to restrict memory usage. By default, the in-link sort as well as external sort stage use 20 MB per partition of memory for buffering purposes. Now, the sort stage provides you an option to increase this restrict memory usage. So if you increase this, and especially if the data and your partitions can fit entirely into a single partition, then it is going to increase the performance of your data sage job. So you can play around with these values and try to improve the performance of your data sage job. Having looked at all these options, we can come to a conclusion that the sort stage provides more options for optimizing job performance as compared to an in-link sort. As a general guideline, it is always a good idea to minimize the occurrence of sort stages, whether they are in-link sorts or external sort stages in our data sage job. And the reason is that every sort stage acts like a speed breaker in your data sage job, because the whole data needs to be read by the sort stage. The next stage has to wait for the sorting to happen, for the output to be produced by the sort stage, and only then it can start processing the data. Perform sorting only on the required keys avoid stable sorts, because stable sorts are going to retain the sorting of the non-key columns, which is not needed in most of the scenarios. So try and avoid the use of stable sorts. It is enabled by default in the external sort stage, so you can go and put the option as false. Then reuse the previously sort keys by using the sort key mode options of don't sort previously grouped or don't sort previously sorted. And another thing that you can do explicitly with the external sort stage is try adjusting the restrict memory usage to see if more memory can be used, and it would help increase the performance of your data stage job. So these are the basic differences between using an in-length sort and an external sort. In-length sort is helpful in simpler cases where you're dealing with less volume of data and you do not have explicit performance issues. If you want to work on improving the performance of the jobs, then you can go for an external sort stage. I hope you liked this video and it helped you. If you did, then please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for many more such videos. Thank you and have a good day.